Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are all doing really well. Today we're going to be going over my monthly fave and fails for the month of December. And basically, I have been testing out so many different products. A lot of stuff is more like beauty stuff, like skincare, kind of like a little different. Not everything is like makeup. So I hope you guys enjoy. There are a few fails, just like one or two. So I feel like this is more of a favorites than fave and fails, but you know, every month is different. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I feel like I'm rambling. If you aren't already subscribed to my channel, I really hope you decide to subscribe. Like the video, really does help out my channel. And as always, let's dive on in and get started in our monthly fave and fails. So the first product that I want to talk about is body soap. And this is something that I honestly really like. And I honestly thought in the beginning that I wasn't going to be a huge fan of, just because it's small. It's not very big. And I think the price to this runs for like, it's a little bit more of a higher end body soap. You know, it's not that affordable. But to be really honest, a little bit of product goes a long way. I personally love the scent to it. This is from the brand called Refreshments Pearly Body Wash. It has a citrusy type of scent, a citrus spritz, and you basically receive 10 fluid ounces. So it's not very much, but I'm not lying to you. A little bit of product goes a long way. It does have a soapy type of scent to it, but I don't feel it to be in a bad way at all. I don't find like it dries out my skin. I love that it creates suds. I just personally really like it. It doesn't over dry my skin, feels really comfortable, and I feel like it lathers really well and it rinses off really well as well. So I don't feel like I have any residue on my skin. The next product is something that I've recently tested out, and this is the 24/7 Retinol Eye Cream with Ruby Crystal Complex. This is from Dr. Brandt, and I'm not sure if this is like full size or sample, but I do receive 0.5 fluid ounces. This is really moisturizing. This is something I use at night as my nighttime skincare routine, and I personally really like it. It's like thick, but it's moisturizing, but I don't feel greasy. It glides on effortlessly, and it really does like soak into your skin. And I personally really like that. It doesn't have a scent to it at all. I love that it comes like in a little tube. It's not a pump. I just find it to be really nice. And it does have like a creamy texture to it. The coloring to it is more of like a like white. And I just personally like it. It doesn't really have a strong scent to it or anything like that. So if you haven't tried it out and you're looking for a really hydrating eye cream, definitely try this one. Next is nail polish, but not just any type of nail polish. This is a clear, fast, quick dry type of nail polish. And this is from, I forget how you pronounce the brand, Basiche Vida. I think that's how you pronounce it. I will have it linked down below. Sorry, I'm not really good at pronunciating names sometimes, but this is the fast dry top coat, and basically I came across this through Amazon. I think this runs for like $12-$15. I could be wrong, but I personally love it. Like, I love the high shine that it gives you. Your nails like look like you got them done or painted at the salon. It holds a shine. It's a really good top coat. It dries really quickly. So especially if you're like needing to, you know, paint your nails really quickly, you need to run out the door because you're running late or something like that, you have a dinner date, this is perfect. Apply it on, it dries really quickly, gives you really nice high shine. So I definitely feel like it's worth it. Makeup brushes. You know I have so many makeup brushes, and I honestly need to cut myself off from buying more, but I honestly love the Laura Lee Los Angeles makeup brushes. She recently launched this collection, which was like limited edition, I think, from my understanding, about a month and a half ago. I was gonna do a review video that ended up not happening, but basically I love her brushes. They are so luxe, you guys, so incredibly soft, so many bristles. Like, if you've been following me for a while, you guys already know I have a thing about brushes having a good amount of bristles. And these brushes, there's so many bristles. Love the handles, love the color to the brushes. I love the L24 brush. I love using this to like blend out my concealer. It just fits perfectly in those little crevices and those little corners around your nose. I just love this little brush. It really does come in handy. And you have so many blending brushes. I love this little fan brush. Like, how fancy, like to apply on your highlighter or even apply on some powder or contour. I personally love it. So if you haven't tried out Laura Lee products, I'd highly suggest it. I just love the affordability. It came with a little cute bag as well, so you can store your brushes for travel. And I just personally really like it, so I'm really excited. And this is kind of the few times that I have purchased products from brands that, you know, influencers have created. I don't know. I just, you know, when I do so many review videos, Maybelline and L'Oreal and so many other brands that everyone is searching for is looking into, and I purchased, if that makes any sense. But a few months ago, I decided, you know what, let's give them a try. Let's see what it's all about. They looked really nice and they caught my eye. Next is a hair mask product that I recently purchased. I went to Ulta. I need a hair mask. I recently got my hair done. You guys know about like 2 months ago in October, and my hair feels a little dry. I'm not even gonna lie. I feel like I need to go back for another haircut, but I'm trying to like take care of my hair a little bit more just to nourish it as much as I can. And I went into Ulta and I was like, girl, I need a hair mask. Help me. What is good? What is out there? And she mentioned to me Eva NYC. I think that's how you pronunciate the brand. You can find this at Ulta. This was around, I think, between $10 to $18, but look at how much product you are receiving. It is a lot. This is 16.9 fluid ounces, and this is the Therapy Session Hair Mask, powdered by plant protein and argan oil. It says no sulfates, no parabens, no, and this is basically all recyclable and vegan and cruelty-free, which you guys know here on my channel. As much as I'm not vegan, I try my best to be, you know, vegan and cruelty-free with products that I review and share with you here on my channel. And to be honest, I personally like it. My biggest tip for you when it comes to this, if you purchase this, would be I notice more results if I put this hair mask in my hair. Say for instance, when I get home from work, it's a Friday night, I'm not going anywhere Saturday early morning, I'm gonna put this on my hair once I get home, once I'm in my PJs, and then I'm gonna sleep with this hair mask in my hair. I'm gonna put a little like shower cap over my head, and then the next morning when I shower, I will obviously rinse this off. My hair is so smooth, more manageable. It's just easier, and I personally really love it. It doesn't weigh it down. It doesn't make it greasy, and I personally love it. I feel like I notice more of a difference when I do that than when I'm in the shower and I play this on and sit there for about 15 minutes letting it soak in. So that is the only thing. The scent to it, you guys, I'm not a fan to the scent, to be really honest, but after I bought it, I was like, I don't want to return it, so I just figured I'd keep using it. The scent to me reminds me of like baby powder. I'm not a fan of the scent. To me it smells kind of like cheap. It smells like Senora. I'm not a huge fan of feeling it to be strong, but the texture, a little bit of product goes a long way. I think I've used it for about a month, and so far personally I really like it, so I'll continue using it. I'll let you guys know how I feel about it if I notice a change or anything like that, but so far so good. Next is something a little different. Talc-free Bond Gold Bond Trusted Soothing Clear Body Powder Spray. This is invisible, goes on clear. This is a unique triple action, absorbs odor, refreshes, cools everything down. You know, I personally really love this. This was a little bit more expensive. Love that it comes down clear. I love spraying this in my shoes, especially office shoes. And I personally love it. It really does absorb the smell, the moisture, and I love that it dries down really quickly. The only thing is the spray is such a pain. It's always, I think I had a defective one, so that is the only thing, but so far, so good. Next is a face powder, and this one is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte Poreless Face Powder. This is shade 220, natural beige. And to be honest, I really love the affordability. I think this was around $5-$6, if I'm correct. I love the fact that it has a nice little, you know, little powder. It comes with a sponge, a mirror. The only thing with this, you guys, is that if you dip your brush into this powder, if you want to apply it with a brush instead of using the little sponge, it flies everywhere. And I'm not a huge fan of that just because I don't want to get it on my clothes, on my hands, on my counters. So that is the only thing. And it definitely gives you a light amount of coverage. Someone like me that I do have hyperpigmentation and do, you know, wear a little bit more medium to full coverage foundation, I need something that's going to give me a little bit more coverage. So I will definitely continue to use this. I feel like their color selection range isn't the best. I wish they had a little bit more variety just because I feel like the shade above this one is a little too dark. And I don't like the idea that I have to almost purchase two different compact powders to kind of, you know, create my shade for me. I do love the little sponge that it comes with. It does a really good job on the application. But yeah, so far so good. I'll continue using it. I personally really like it. It comes through and it gives me a really nice flawless finish. Gel polish, because this is something that I've been using actually off and on throughout the past like 2 years since COVID, when no one was able to go to the nail salon, I was actually using this for a good minute. I forgot to mention it to you guys. And this is actually something that was sent to me. Thank you so much, Cassidy, for sending it to me. I think that's how you pronunciate the brand. But basically for like $16, $18, it's really affordable. You receive six different gel polishes in your little kit. You also receive a matte top coat if you want your gel nail polish to look matte. You also receive your base coat, and you also receive a glossy top coat. And let me tell you, this glossy top coat, you don't always have to just use it with the gel polish. You can even use this above any of your regular nail polish, like paint your nails, apply this over, obviously put them in your little light, and that is basically it. And it'll prolong, you know, the wear of your polish. And I personally like it. I even actually recently used it for my nails. I actually need to repaint them, but I went to go get my nails done at the salon. They didn't do the best job, so I went in and fixed them and reapplied the clear gel, and I used the one I have, and it did a really great job. It gave me a really beautiful shiny finish. I wouldn't say it's the, you know, the best, like the salon, but definitely does a job, and it looks really, really nice on. And talking about the gel nail polish, we obviously have to talk about the LED UV, you know, little gel polish cooker. I got this one from Amazon and I absolutely love it. I think it was like under $30 and it does a really, really good job. I love it. I use it every single time I apply on my gel. And I personally really like it. I love the affordability. I keep it in its little box just because I want to keep it in good condition. And I personally really like it. It hasn't given me any issues. Obviously, it's a little bit big, so you're going to have to make storage. But overall, it's really good. So if you're looking for a little UV LED, you know, little gel polish cooker, definitely try this one. Next is press-on nails. And as you guys probably noticed in my last video, I didn't have any nails on. I kind of took them off just because my real nails underneath felt really thin. So I felt like I needed a little break so they can recoup, so we can go back to, you know, wearing acrylics. But basically in that little time period that I've been, you know, MIA here on my channel, I have been playing around with press-on nails. I recently tried Glamnetic press-ons. These are reusable, obviously. I bought their kit that came with like three different styles, and it also, I think it also came with their brush-on nail glue within the kit. I think it was like $50, $40. I really love the affordability of it. It makes it really convenient. They're shipping, you guys. Let me just tell you, it is really, really fast, which is a big plus. And I personally really love that because if you're like, you want them now, you're gonna get them right away. At least in my opinion, I got it really quickly. I think it took like within 2 to 3 days, I received my order. But to be really honest, I'm not a huge fan of the nails. Unfortunately, I just find them to be the style of it. I don't know if it's the shape of the nail bed of it. I just don't like the shape of it. It's not for me. I don't feel like it looks natural in my opinion. They do feel really thin. I feel like if I'm gonna make my bed and stick my nails in to like tuck in the bed sheet, it's gonna fold really easily. I just don't feel like they're sturdy enough for me, but I do like them. I did wear them out when I was out, and I did use the nail glue, and I did find the nail glue consistency to be really interesting just because the container is just, you think by looking at it, it's gonna be kind of like super glue, you know, but it actually isn't. You brush on the nail glue on your nail or directly on your personal nail, and that is basically it. The consistency of it feels more like a gel than a glue, like a super glue kind of texture. So that is the only thing, but it held up my nails really well. I put them on really quickly one night, and I had them on for 7 days and none of them fell off. I didn't even feel like they were budging whatsoever, but definitely having them on, I felt like they were thin. So that's the only thing. But so far, personally, I like the glue. I definitely can't wait to continue using it. I'm gonna put it in my kit, try them out when I'm using my static nails. So I'll keep you guys posted. But as for the nails, I just wasn't a huge fan. It wasn't for me, the shape. I don't know, something about it. It just, It just wasn't for me. Now for the last and final product that I have here, because I'm going to hold it up so you can see what I'm talking about. So when I first started doing brush set review videos here on my channel, I didn't really have many brushes to begin with. And as you do so many review videos, you start accumulating, you know, products and brushes and makeup and things like that. So I originally started with these kind of like pen holder cups that I found at Target. And eventually I started getting more and more, collecting more and more brushes that I ended up buying more of these pencil holders or little cups. And essentially now I have so many of these little pencil holder cups that I'm like, oh my God, I have like six of them. It was getting so frustrating to have to like pull them all out, and I don't have them displayed in my bathroom because I don't have enough counter space. So I went on Amazon recently and I was like, let me see if I can find something that I feel like will probably be big enough where I can store all of my makeup brushes. And girl, let me show you, because I have to use both of my hands, what I'm talking about. And this is basically it. I absolutely love it. It's made out of acrylic. It's from the brand called N2 Makeup Co. I will have it linked down below. And it fits all of my brushes like perfectly. I do have other makeup brushes that I have aside stored away for like emergencies, but this is kind of like my go-to, and I personally really love it. It's kind of hard to pick up because it's so heavy, but I love the idea that everything is one in one place. I have all of my face brushes on one side and all of my eyeshadow brushes on the other. And it's really affordable. I think it was like $22, $23, but I feel like this will last you a really long time. And you have different colors that you can pick. I think they had this one in clear and they also had it in black, but I really liked it in black. So I personally really, really like it. So if you're looking for something like this, definitely try this one out. All right, you guys, this is basically it. I hope you enjoyed this month's monthly fave and fails for the month of November. I had so much fun trying out new products, sharing you what I've been, you know, getting myself into behind the scenes for the past like month and a half that I haven't been here on, been active here on my channel. Comment down below what has been your monthly faves or your monthly fails, like products you've tried and you're like, oh my God, what is this? I'm not happy. I'll use it though because I have it, but I wish I would have purchased this, you know? I hope you guys enjoyed. Everything will be linked down below. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you have any video suggestions, also comment down below. And as always, I will see you all in my next video. I love you all so, so much. Bye!